Visit G2A.com for the lowest digital game prices on the market. What's going on, guys? Blame Truth here, the Godfather himself, bringing you another video. In this particular match, I'm just going to say this right off the bat, I get a nuke, and it sucks. This is the first nuke I've gotten since they've come out with it. The conditions were perfect. I'm playing Domination. My team was actually good, and the enemy team was average to below average, so it worked out. Also, I play this very, very scummy. I know Slum's like the back of my hand. I know the sight lines and whatnot, so I play this like I'm kind of an MLG Dallas, and that's the extent of it. With that said, the nuke is terrible. First time I've gotten it, why does it kill me if it doesn't end the game? In Modern Warfare 2, it killed everybody, but it ended the game. In Modern Warfare 3, it only killed the enemy team. It was the Moab. And it gave your team double XP for the rest of the game. It EMP'd the enemy. In this, it just kills everyone. The game doesn't end, and then everybody awkwardly respawns. Not to mention, if your teammates are on streaks, it resets those. It kills them and resets them. What a bonehead, dumbass feature. Worst nuke I have ever seen in a Call of Duty. So stupid, dude. But anyway, let's get into the meat and potatoes here. This is a slightly longer gameplay because I want to cover something that has been bugging me for a while. And it's pretty much been confirmed now that this is just going to be, like, COD World War II Vanguard, it's just going to be a reskin of Modern Warfare. That's what it is. It's going to be a reskin of Modern Warfare. It is going to have some destruction elements like Battlefield. That's it. You just put a World War II skin on it. It's going to be the same exact game. I was actually kind of wondering, like, why are people saying Vanguard looks so good? You know, despite saying a couple months ago it was in a bad state, they were really rushed. And I realized why. They just took Modern Warfare and changed some textures. Added some destructibility. Their two jobs were changing the textures and adding the destructibility. Infinity Ward has already, like, basically made this game for Sledgehammer my balls. And, guys, basically all Sledgehammer is doing is adding in features that are trash. I want to know, in the comments section right now, I want to know, who in the fuck asked for weapon mounting where you could slide around, you could slide your gun around while you mount? Who asked for blind fire? Who asked for that feature? Did anyone in the comments section ask for this? Now, I got a better one. Did anyone ask for this? Doors are also back. Yes. There's an option to select how door mechanics work in the settings. Door mechanics. Door mechanics. Yeah. What does that entail? I read that and I laughed. I laughed really, really hard because I just thought back to, oh, I don't know, when I first started playing Call of Duty. And my very first Call of Duty was Call of Duty 4 Modern Warfare on the Xbox 360 back in 2007. Long time ago. And I remember playing that game for a year, and then World at War came out. And I played that game for a year, and then Modern Warfare 2 was announced. And I remember thinking, like, man, what are they going to put in Modern Warfare 2 that's really going to, like, change the game and make it awesome, you know? And they put in, like, customizable streaks, you know? They put in, well, some not-so-good stuff like Danger Close Noob Tubes and Commando Lunging. But they had some good ideas overall, like customizable streaks, you know? Better perk balance, stuff like that. Now, imagine you're a COD gamer in 2021. You just started playing COD with Cold War, and you're thinking, man, I wonder what kind of features they're going to add to World War II Vanguard. Oh God. And the first thing you see when you get on Twitter is Charlie Intel confirming they're adding in fucking door mechanics. Door mechanics! What does that even mean? So, there's destructibility in Vanguard, right? So, like, people are saying, well, I don't mind that doors are returning. You can blow them up now. You can destroy them. It's no big deal. But, like, why even put them there then? Why put them there if all you can do is shoot them or camp behind them? It adds nothing to the gameplay. And what's the door mechanics feature even for? Is it gonna make them indestructible? Like, is that an option? Is it gonna make them paper mache and you can blow them down like the big bad wolf? Is it gonna make the door texture just a scanned image of Joe Sekot's ball sack? What's it for? Is there a mechanic where I can, like, stick my pecker through a little hole in the crack in the door? What's it for? Why are they coding in door mechanics? Guys, I kind of joke around about suplexing Joe Sekot. I don't actually want to hurt Joe Sekot. I don't. I don't really care about the man, actually. I have no interest in ever meeting him or talking to him or any of that stuff. So it's really just a catchphrase at this point. But it all stems from the fact that Modern Warfare, and I'm sorry, but I'm going to say this, and I don't care if you dislike me, because guess what? You're wrong if you dislike me because of this. I'm sorry, but you are. Modern Warfare is a Call of Duty designed from the ground up to supplement bad players. The game is designed for shitbirds and noobs. It literally is. Joe Sekot says this in an interview. And one of these things in the game, the worst feature ever in Call of Duty history, has been the freaking doors. The doors in Modern Warfare multiplayer are the number one reason I didn't even play the damn game. Like, I played the beta, and I played several hours of the full game, and I decided that this game is unsavable. There's the shitty maps, yeah. I can kind of get around that. You know, I got around it in World War II, like the original COD World War II, not Vanguard, but I got around it with that. I can kind of deal with that. It really sucks, but I can deal with it. I can kind of deal with safe spaces. A lot of the old Call of Duties had safe spaces. That's fine. I cannot deal with doors made by NASA that swing open both ways, can be opened and closed, offer an audio cue to campers, destroy the flow of the map, the arcade shooter that is Call of Duty. And if anyone tries to argue realism here, these doors are indestructible, man. These doors are made out of freaking, I don't know, some kind of superhuman substance. You can't blow them up. Now, you can blow them up in Vanguard, apparently, but it doesn't matter. They shouldn't be in the damn game to start with. Guys, listen. Planting claymores behind doors does not make you good. Planting your ass behind the door and aiming at it, waiting for it to open so you can shoot, does not make you good. All doors do is make the game worse. Why do we need them? And why in the fuck do we need an option in the menu to change them in some way? Maybe it's to, like, take them out? Which, if that's the case, don't even put them in! I don't get it. Why are you wasting dev time making blind fire features, making a door mechanics option, putting the doors in to start with? No one asked for doors. In fact, so many people hated doors that they took them out of Cold War entirely. Thank God. And you know what? I don't like Cold War, but at the very least, they had enough sense to give us some decent maps and not put doors everywhere. I don't get it. I don't get it. Why are all three studios not on the same page? Why can't Treyarch just be like, hey, other two COD devs, doors are a bad idea. Take them the hell out. Entirely. Why can't they do that? Guys, I am a very good Call of Duty player. I chose this gameplay because I am getting a nuke. And while that doesn't mean like I'm the best player ever, obviously, I'm like top 1% stat-wise in public matches. You know, in basically every Call of Duty I've bothered to play. Been playing Call of Duty for 14 years. Guys, doors are the worst feature in Call of Duty history. They do nothing, they offer nothing but making the game worse. And all of these features in Vanguard, guys, Tax Sprint is back, if you didn't know. It's a reskin of Modern Warfare. And I am sorry, but Modern Warfare 2019 and most good players, especially those with YouTube channels like mine, they agree that Modern Warfare 2019 is the worst Call of Duty ever. If you have a brain! If you're a smooth brain, if you're a Riri, if you eat paste by the spoonful, yeah, it's probably pretty good. You can marvel at the nice glossy animations. Oh, look how smooth my gun reloads. Take that smooth gun, turn it sideways, and shove it up your ass! Modern Warfare is dog shit. Vanguard is going to be Modern Warfare with more dog shit features, and I'm calling it right now. It will be the worst Call of Duty of all time. I don't even need to play it because I've already played it. In 2019, I played it. Joe Sekhot's wet dream. I'm done. I hope you guys enjoyed. I'm out. I want to suplex Joe Sekhot through the core of the earth. I'll see you guys later. Peace.